Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. When I was at the seminary, I tried to figure out a great secret, which is, how do I write and give a good sermon? What can I do to prepare myself so that the faithful can hear my words and listen to them so that they may retain the teachings of the scriptures? And some may say that, well, Father, you have to prepare. You have to be able to relate with the people and to give them something that they can remember. And others might say, well, Father, maybe a story or a joke to lighten up the mood. But the reality is that the person responsible for hearing a good sermon is you. The person responsible for understanding and hearing and opening their hearts to hear the gospel is you. In today's scripture reading, there are seeds that are thrown into the ground. And it did not matter in what form this seed took place, or in how it went to the ground, or in what way it was presented to the ground, or if it said a joke while it was hitting the ground. The seed fell upon the ground, and it depended on the type of soil, the type of earth that the seed fell upon, that was going to dictate how the seed grew. And in the scripture reading today, it talks about what it takes to prepare soil. And out of my curiosity last night, I Googled, what does it take to enrich the soil? And in many different instances, to add nutrients, to add moisture, to add water, to all these things in order to prepare the soil. What are we doing to prepare our hearts to hear the Word of God? What are we doing to prepare our souls to receive the body and blood of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ? Because many of us might leave church and say, Father didn't really say anything important, church was fine. But then my question for you is, what did you do last night? My question for you is, what did you do this morning? Did we have a calm night the night before to prepare ourselves to hear the Word of God and to receive the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist? Did we say some prayers this morning and spend some time in silence, especially in the car ride coming to church? Or did we quickly check the scores of the football games? Or did we listen to our favorite song on the radio? How are we preparing ourselves to receive the Word of God? Because Christ makes it very clear that if we do not work, if we do not till the ground to prepare a seed for it to grow, then how can we possibly maintain and sustain the Word of God within the depths of our hearts without first preparing ourselves to hear that Word? I pray that as we continue to hear the Holy Scripture, we continue throughout the divine liturgy, that we do not just go through the motions, but we are attentive. We hear the prayers read by the priest. We may hear the words chanted by the choir and by all of us, so that truly with the fear of God, with faith and with love, we may draw near to receive the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist, and that we may prepare ourselves to hear the Word of God, that once we leave this church, it may not fall away to hard soil, to rock, to be eaten up by the thorns, but may find good soil within the depths of our hearts, that we may continue to live and preach and act a life pleasing to God and adhering to the gospel. Amen.